guys, Tami Duggar, CJ Stryker, Stryker Network Live, S&M Studios here in New York. Yes, for the record, S&M, Stryker, S, Network N, Media M, S&M Studios. How are you?
I'm great, how are you?
Good, I should put my glasses up.
There probably.
Yeah, so how was your last few days and stuff? I know I saw you last week, but...
Well, I was accosted by mosquitoes, and in case anybody was wondering, the number one home remedy for mosquito bites is toothpaste, not itchy cream. Itchy cream doesn't work. Toothpaste works.
Really?
Toothpaste paste, works? Not gel. Yeah, it really works. It makes it feel, I have about 12 on one ankle and about 14 on the other. And the only thing that has been able to let me sleep at night, toothpaste. So, stock up, kids.
This is why, like, on episode 7, you saw me scratching my legs. I was getting murdered out here by mosquitoes. That's why I didn't wear cologne this time.
Ah.
I got smart.
That's why I'm wearing pants.
So.
Because I don't want you to see, I look like a heroin addict. It looks like, you know, what is that called? Track marks. It looks like I've got track marks, but it's mosquitoes.
Okay. So, that's sad. What's happened since July 1st? Oh, yeah. So, apparently, O.J. Simpson, take two with Casey Anthony.
Oh.
What the fuck?
Guys, this is somber for me. I find this absolutely reprehensible and disgusting. All right, check this out. If you wait 31 days to pay your electric bill, they shut you off. If you wait 31 days to pay your cell phone bill, they shut you off. But you wait 31 days to report your 2-year-old missing and they let you off. That is it. Florida's gotta go. I'm sick of Florida. The only good thing about Florida is the New Yorkers that went there to live. So I'm saying I'm recalling all the New Yorkers and we're chopping Florida off. They deserve a little punishment. After what they did with that re-election, fuck Florida. Sorry, Florida, but fuck you.
You're right and wrong about that. I'm gonna tell you why. They granted me an extension and clemency on my driving school so I don't get points on my license because I got pulled over in December.
Yeah.
So they're being a little, they're very lenient.
At the same time, Florida is where Al-Qaeda went to learn how to fly our planes before they crashed them into the World Trade Center.
That does suck.
Yeah, so one up, one down.
Oh, I still love Florida. It's a vacation spot. I go there. My sister lives there. Hey, sis. Hey, Erica. Love you guys. Hey,
I like
Josh.
The people in Florida.
Oh, by the way. Carlos,
sort of.
Venice Charles, hey, and Josh, you sexy fuck, I miss you, man.
Venice, hi, I haven't seen you in a while.
So, with that said, welcome to episode 8, the Long Island Social System. It's into 4 parts. Today we talk about part 1. So, over the last 2 weeks I've done all the bars, and you know what, guys, I've learned a lot. I've learned a lot about the bars. I am very happy that, you know, we do have a social system in Long Island, even though there's a lot to improve on. That's all I'm gonna say. Now, unfortunately, this brings me to a very bad piece of news. Roosters in North Belmore is now closed indefinitely. The details beyond that is really an internal matter and it will not be discussed. But I want to thank Dean Vasali for everything he's done. I know he's going to do everything in his power to reopen Roosters. But until then, I just want to let everybody know that Dean Vasali is a Good Times Bar and Lounge in North Belmore on Monday nights. If you love to go see him, he will be there. Now, as far as the rest of the gay community, and especially the gay community in Nassau County, with Roosters closed, you all need a new gay bar to go to. I now fully endorse and support Blanche Bar in Farmingdale, and Blanche will be in part 2 of Stryker Network Live. But with that said, now we move on to our very first venue, the Eagle. Welcome to the Long Island Eagle. Address, 94 North Clinton Avenue in Bayshore. Owner and operator of the Eagle, Brett Pellicone. Additionally, the Eagle, like all Eagles throughout the country, the bars we talk about, are known to attract the traditional, older, rugged gentlemen who are into leather. Brett has transformed this Eagle into a modern-day gay bar. Why is it called Veranda? He'll explain it to you a little later. When did it first open? We'll ask them too. Let's go inside and take a look. There in the laptop is the proprietor, operator, and owner of Eagle Brick Pelican, and he's with his entourage. This is Garrett Mouser. You'll be seeing him for the bunkhouse segment. This is Joey Tempo, one of the bartenders here at the Long Island Eagle. Joey, how do you like working here?
Tommy loves it. Best place to work. Really.
Cool. And he's making me a cranberry vodka?
Yes, I am.
Perfect.
That's for you, baby.
Thank you. So let me ask you a question. As a bartender here at this venue, at the Eagle, how hard is it? How hard is it to run around and get everyone's drinks in time? And your experience as you just being a bartender, what's your experience like?
I have a lot of support from the owner, obviously, Brett. He always helps me out with what I need. So it's like we work together as a family. So everybody's here, they're always helping out. And when we come in, we always help each other. So it's never a problem.
Like, he's not even working tonight.
I'm not even working.
Ladies and gentlemen.
See, we're the family.
Joey Tempo, bartender at the Eagle.
JT.
Well, I'm with Ricardo Rodriguez, coordinator for the Latin Night here in the Long Island social system, and more preferably, tonight at the Eagle. How are you?
Good, how are you?
Good. By the way, happy birthday.
Thank you so much.
So, tell me about the Latin Night here at the Eagle. Its history, when did you start it?
Well, the Latin Night here at the Eagle started with, I've had this idea for a long time, since Thunders was around, to have a Latin Night. Unfortunately, a lot of the club promoters or the club owners did not want to mix the night on a Saturday or a Friday. They would try to do it another night. So, yeah, I did one or two at the Thunders. That didn't stick. But Vinny, being that he's an avid lover of Latinos, he gave me his Sunday once a month, and that's how it started. I also partake a group called Hola G, which is Organización Latina Asociada Gay. Basics, a group of Latinos that got together and try to spread the word of Latin LGBT.
Okay. What is your relationship with the rest of the bar owners here in Long Island and with their other venues?
All right. Basically, the relationship I have, I know a lot of them. As far as me extending my parties to their venues, it's very difficult. They're not welcoming, as far as I don't feel that they're welcoming to let us in and maybe mix a night on a Saturday, do sets. I went to a club when I was growing up, when I was too young to go into clubs, but I went to a club called Crash. And that format of the music, where it was some Latin, more house, some Latin, more house, it was a nice venue, and they were around for many, many years. I think it was over 10 years. So
wow.
I try to put that in.
Back.
Yeah, I try to put that in there, but they don't want to do it. They want to give me a Wednesday or a Thursday, and it doesn't work for Latinos.
What do you think should happen to strengthen up the awareness of all the bars here as far as socially? Like, a lot of people have told me that that there's not a lot of awareness of all the bars that are opening, the publicity's too low. What do you think should be done to make that happen?
Well, really, all the bar rags are pretty much gone. There used to be so many of them, and where to get those bar rags? They can't leave them just anywhere, meaning the magazines. There was Long Island Pride Press that was gone. There was MAPP, which is also another one that was from Long Island Pride Press. So there's not many magazines out there telling people where to go, so everything's gone internet. And if somebody don't have a computer, they don't know how to get to it. So I believe Facebook is gonna be the way of the future to let people know where to go. You know, I jump on Facebook at any given moment and you see 6 parties already got invitations to all throughout the island, which is very good.
Good. So what are your hopes for the future?
My hopes for the future for Long Island is basically have more places open up. Because we're so sparse and so long, it's very difficult to have people come to one night only. So what I suggest is, hey, you know what? All the club owners get together and do something collaboratively together and you're not stepping on anybody's toes, you're not giving any attitude, no shade, no nothing like that, because there really is business for everyone.
So with that said, I'm going to ask an attachment to that question.
Okay.
So we have a thing called Barnite.
Right.
So you were saying that the Barnite could probably be better.
Absolutely. Barnite, from what I experienced, is the only people that show up, really, as the bar owners and things like that. There's patrons to listen to what's going on. Isn't really going. I didn't see any people in the last Barnite that was paying attention. I think it should be taken a little more seriously. I believe respect and letting the other bar owners speak clearly and maybe even pass out maybe an 8.5 by 10 flyer, something that gives you a lineup of what's going on to people there so people know, or a calendar of events, because really, people forget and not let people show up.
I think you're right. I think communication is a stronger communication, because we are lacking that. Ricardo Rodriguez, Latinx coordinator for Long Island, thank you very much.
No problem. Thank you, CJ.
Operator and owner of the Eagle here in Long Island. How are you, Brett?
I'm great, thanks.
So, Brett, tell me, when did the Eagle first open?
We are in our 20th year this year. As a matter of fact, we're in November, probably the first week in November, we're going to have our 20th year anniversary for the Long Island Eagle here in Bayshore.
Awesome. Now, I noticed that the big sign says veranda at the Long Island Eagle.
Yes.
Why?
Just to confuse people. I thought, let me find the best way I can to confuse people. No. Because we're promoting for the summer the patio space, which is veranda at the Long Island Eagle. Everybody says, oh, I noticed you changed the name. The bar is not called the Long Island Eagle anymore. And I asked them, did you read it? So anyway, we're promoting veranda at the Long Island Eagle for the summer. Special events out on the patio, acoustic guitar players at night, and jugglers and circus freaks, but I'm kidding. But anyway, special events on veranda. And that's why we're promoting it for the summer. October 1st, the brand new Eagle sign will go back up, or up for the first time, and it's going to be our entire new logo and new marketing.
Okay. How do you feel about your relationship with the rest of the Long Island bar system here?
I feel great about it.
Okay. And what are your hopes going forward for your business in the future and for the island at large?
I thought you wouldn't let me get away with that last one with that simple answer, but I will elaborate a little bit. The other bars, I have no problem with any of the other bars. There's the owners and all. We're pretty good with each other. And I have heard of a time. I'm not a Long Island native, but I've heard of a time here on Long Island where there were 20 bars, you know, all doing really well. And I understand the internet has changed the bar business and this and that. It has changed the bar business. Some people just aren't around anymore. But there's definitely room for the 5 or 6 or less that are here. So I have no problem with the other bars. I actually appreciate the other bars, and I'm sad to hear when one closes, because that means Long Island isn't in a draw for people to stick around. People want choices, and if they're going to drive here and we're not having a great night, they want to know that really close by, within a short distance, they can drive to another bar. So I hope none of them close down, and I don't mind when new ones open. So now, my hopes for the future of the Long Island Eagle, I want to not close down. I want to stay in business. And I want to do well. I don't want to make a mint. I want to make a modest amount of money that can pay my bills here and keep my mortgage paid at home. And I want to offer a really good product for everybody here on Long Island.
Personally, I think you've revolutionized this bar, and you're doing an amazing job, Brett.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Thanks for talking with me.
Go, Brett!
So, Tami, what'd you think of it?
I really like the footage. I really always liked the Eagle. It's been around for a long time. I've been there a million times. I always like the vibe in the place. The people are always really cool. The music's always really cool. I like the actual feel of the venue. I always have. So, you know, it's a great place. It really is. Unfortunately, living where I live, it's a little far from me, which is a problem with all the bars on the island. They're so spread out. So,
yeah, Brett revolutionized the Eagle in so many ways. There is one concern I have, or one possible constructive criticism I have about it. The brand Eagle has been known traditionally as the symbol of the leather community nationwide.
Right.
Now, something I'm thinking is that if Brett's trying to revolutionize the gay bar to go beyond such a, beyond the leather community and something more generalized, he might want to consider changing the name altogether and not calling it Eagle anymore. Only because a lot of people that live in different states who, I've told them, there's a New York Eagle, there's a Long Island Eagle. And these are all people in the real leather community who go, it's another leather bar? I'm like, no, it's not a leather bar. This Eagle is not traditional as the other Eagles. This one is just a regular gay bar. And a lot of people tell me, well, then they shouldn't call it the Eagle because the Eagle is not, the Eagle is a symbol of the leather community. And when you go to the Houston Eagle, when you go to Fort Lauderdale's Eagle, Washington, Boston, you know, any other city that has an Eagle, Boston doesn't have an Eagle, but any other city that has an Eagle, it's normally the headquarters of the leather community. And, you know, now technically, the Eagle in Long Island is home to the Long Island Ravens. However, at this time, I don't think they want to, I think they're trying to move their base somewhere else altogether.
Possible.
I don't think I'm supposed to say that, but you know what? When I see the Ravens in other locations now, you can only assume.
Well, they could. They don't have to necessarily change the whole name. I mean, they could make it cute, like, you know, non-traditional Eagle. Or, you know, something like that.
Yeah.
How about, you know, no leather, bald eagle?
That's true. No, ultimately, Brett, listen, the decision is yours, buddy. I am just saying that this is what I've gotten, you know, through my travels. And, you know, you're the man. It's your bar. But I stick behind it. You are doing an amazing job at the bar. I'm just saying, you know, the name is something worth thinking about if you decided going forward to continue to change up, you know, the bar to attract the Long Island audience. With that said, you know what? I'm in the mood to bash somebody right now.
Ooh!
Avanti Twist!
Oh.
Which I just found out yesterday at bar night that the bar's no more. They ended it. They
put Shocking!
A stop to it. They put a stop to it. Apparently, according to one of my sources, it was poorly run and it's kaput. It's done.
According to one or every one of your sources?
No, one of my sources.
I mean, I could easily say it was poorly run. I was there. It was a nightmare. You know.
You know, first of all, we'll get into the false advertisement later. But
yeah.
I did manage to take away this clip from Twist that I thought was very funny. I would like to share it with you guys.
Well, the thing about Twist was I was concerned that there were a lot of, you know, straight people there. Not to say that that's a bad thing. We love our straight brothers and sisters. It's just that, you know, if you're advertising, you know, big rainbows all everywhere, and I'm looking around and I'm just seeing lots of guys, you know, looking awfully straight. I was like, what is this? Because I, you know, I was getting the eyes from a couple guys, and I'm like, look, I'm not here to beat off Guidos. You know, I'm here to hang out.
Fist pumping Jersey Shore! But there's this straight dude that was there. My name is Mr. Kyle Rose, straight as a pin.
Straight as a line, no curves.
Tammy, let's show him. What's your name and where are you from?
Ray Cairo, from Medford.
Cool, what are you doing here tonight?
Showing my gay cousin Charlie, right over there with the yellow.
The you know.
That would be gay Charlie.
Yep.
We see you, gay Charlie, we got you.
I got gay Charlie on video.
It's okay, yep. Don't worry about it.
We got my girl over there, Tasha.
Hi, Tasha.
The midget.
Tasha's not really a midget. We apologize
really
to
not.
All midgets out there.
She's not a midget,
she is
but she's
fun
under
fun
my
side.
Level.
So what brings you? So, but what brings you to act to Avanti Twist tonight?
Besides Charlie,
my girl.
What?
My girl brought me here.
Oh, your girl brought you here.
Yeah. So you all know, right. I gotta be in there chilling.
You
get my dance on, my drink on.
Cool.
You know how we do.
Excellent. Have you been here
for
before?
For the record, you're a heterosexual.
For the record?
Yes.
Ray Cairo. There you go. Straight as a pin. Yeah. Nothing curved in this body.
Nicely done.
All right.
You have curves. This is.
Hi, gay Charlie!
And I'm Ray Cairo from Medford. I'm straight as a pin.
I'm just Ray. You know, my girlfriend's a midget because she's shorter than me. That was offensive.
Yo, seriously, Ray? I can imagine him. He's probably hung like a horse and thick as hell. The man probably knows. I'm sorry. I think he was kind of His face could have been better, but you know, I like his body.
You know, he looks like he could dance. At the same time, he thinks that does protest too much. I think he cried at Steel Magnolias. I really do.
He looks like he could fuck. He probably breaks her in two.
She probably breaks him in two, and he probably cries when they're done.
So, anyway.
You never know, those little girls.
I know, right? That was probably the funniest event that happened at Twist that night, because let me tell you, I went out to Walmart, and you know what, Tami? I was at Walmart when this whole thing happened. This was your situation.
Okay, so we were asked by the DJ to come down and possibly, you know, squeeze them into our episode here, and we complied. You know, we're cool. We're nice, right? Everybody gets in. So we went down there, and well, there was supposed to be open bar. It was complimentary admission from 10 to 11 and open bar from 10 to 11. I get my first drink. It was a, you know, shot glass full of cranberry juice. Fine, typical open bar stuff. I'm not complaining about that. I get my second drink, another shot glass full of cran. I'm done. I go to get my third, and Danny, the bartender, says, that'll be $9.
Wait, what?
Yeah, $9.
Open bar means unlimited drinks for that hour.
No kidding. I know what open bar means. I'm sure you guys know what open bar means. Evidently, Danny didn't know what open bar meant. It really wasn't even their fault. It was actually the owners that completely screwed it up. And not for nothing, I mean, $9 for a weak drink in a Dixie cup, even if, I mean, I don't know. Were we in the village? Were we in the city when that one? No, we were in...
It might look like we might have been in the city.
We were in frigging Westbury, so they had some nerve. I did not take that third drink. I could buy several gallons of cranberry juice for $9.
Now, let me tell you what happened when I got there. I got there at 10:45, 15 minutes remaining for the open bar. And I wasn't out to get drunk. I was out to have one drink. And let me tell you, that bartender looked my way twice in those 15 minutes, did not come my way. At 11 o'clock, he finally comes up to me and says, hey, what can I get for you? I'm like, you know what? I'm leaving. It took 15 minutes. You waited till 11 o'clock so you could start charging me? Fuck you.
You know what else happened? I went to the other bartender by the name of Angel, and I was going to introduce myself, let him know what we were doing there and everything else. There was a guy to the right of me and a guy to the left of me. He looks at the guy to the right of me, looks right over me, and turns to the guy to the left of me that just got there and says, what can I get you? I looked right at him and I said, that was a mistake. And he gave me this dirty look and why? Like, how could I have made a mistake with you, girl? And I explained who I was and what we were doing there and the fact that he just ignored me and it was going on the show. And then it was all backpedaling. No, I would never do that. What could I get for you, honey? And I was like, no, it's okay, Angel. It's fine. You don't have to get me anything, sweet pea.
Hey,
he's gonna be in the show.
You two Twinkies, listen to me right now. Everyone is a tipper. Girl, guy, straight, gay. Everyone tips, okay? And let me tell you, you're there to work. You're not there to be a slut and hook up with the billions of customers that are twink-like people that you want, okay? This is a message to all club promoters, all bartenders out there. Everyone is a customer. Treat them as such, because you never know who's going to be an amazing tipper that night or when you're gonna go on camera and when you're gonna get either good or bad publicity. Guess what? Now, granted, Twist has put it Avanti, and a message to the owners of Avanti. Listen, guys, if you're not going to support the gay community, don't let another promoter on behalf of the gay community come and ask to do a night there if you're going to fuck them over. Because let me tell you something. As of right now, Avanti's on my shit list, and don't be surprised at a later episode, I come in candid and attack you guys, because I can't.
Right.
My name is CJ Stryker, and this is Tami Duggar, and we're not to be fucked with. A message to the rest of the promoters in Long Island. All the gay promoters. Choose your venues wisely, and stop choosing these pathetic places where they're gonna fuck us over. It's not good for business. It really isn't. Now, really quickly, Tami, I wanna show the flyer real quick.
Okay. Yeah, make sure you take a look.
Take a look. Funnier note. How's your love life lately?
Well, all right. This is going to become like a new segment, I'm pretty sure, of Tami's jacked up love life. But she asked for it, she got it. Her name's Liz, and she's going down. Not farther than she already went, but down. Okay, so a good friend of mine's sister tells me she likes me. Great. She's cute. I like her sister a lot. You know, I've already met her. They're very similar people. You know, I'm thinking, yeah, you know, branch out, stretch out of your normal, you know, comfort zone and meet some new people, hang out with some new people. She asked me to come to where she lives in Kew Gardens, and I went, dutifully, like the little bitch I am, evidently. And,
I'm having a beer.
It was a fucking nightmare. I get there, the girl is so disrespectful. She's wearing a do-rag and doesn't even have a bra on. I don't know what that was supposed to be saying to me. Either it was supposed to be get on your knees and suck my tit, or I don't care enough about you or respect you enough to put on a bra. We hung out that night, and if you could feel my seething anger, you could kind of figure out possibly what went down. Then I never got called again. Not because I'm bad at what I do, but because she's a bitch. Did you ever consider I was on the same page, Liz, and I didn't want to hang out with you ever again either? I mean, seriously, get over yourself. Your sister's cooler than you anyway, and from what I understand, you're socially retarded. So, go be a good EMT, save lives, and leave live people to people that know how to speak, because you kind of suck. And by the way, you asked me, well, you didn't ask me, you told me to make you pancakes. You found out I could cook and you said, yay, I'm getting pancakes. Let me tell you something, woman. If you were dying of a pancake deficiency and Aunt Jemima was the only thing that would save your life, I still wouldn't make your dumbass pancakes.
Wow. Wow. Yeah. I can't say anything about that, but wow. Mm. Let this be a lesson to you ladies. Don't ever think that this girl is a pushover, because she's not. She's the greatest girl in the world. She's great to date. I don't know from experience, of course, I'm a gay guy, but she's great to date, and she's probably she is a great friend. But don't cross her. Because when you cross her, that's just not good. Not to mention,
you mess with the bull, you get the horns, you know what I'm saying?
And you go on the, and you, it gets put on the air, guys. Come on. Well, Liz, congratulations. She just made you famous on Stryker Network Live.
It was your mistake. It was yours to make. But now, dear girl, you're in episode 8.
Oh, God. I got to go back a quick second to the flyer. I apologize. I completely forgot because I wanted to, like, remind you about Liz. But so, yeah, guys, if you saw the flyer, open bar. It said open bar.
Open.
Not two complimentary drinks, open bar.
Open.
That's called a false advertisement.
And it's illegal. And unethical.
Yeah.
And we were also given these cards. Do you have your card?
Shit, I do. Hold on a minute. Excuse me a minute. So
we were given these awesome cards when we walked in. And, I kept mine because I thought it was pretty cool.
Yeah. Hold on.
Where's yours?
It's in here. I'm just trying to put my wallet. There we go.
Okay. So, shall we? Yeah. It says admit.
One fierce bitch.
Well, let me tell you something. This fierce bitch was really, really thirsty. Thirsty! You guys suck! But your cards were cool. Not that cool.
Well, now we, with that said, okay, I'm putting that behind us. It's yesterday's news.
It is now.
let's move on to a nice venue, a good venue. A place that has an amazing place. It's an amazing place to go to. It just opened. It's one of the newest bars in Suffolk County in Patchogue. I'm talking about Alfie's.
Oh, Alfie's. We liked Alfie's.
With a great friend of mine, George Colin Tuno. Finally got his name right.
Tuno.
Let's say it together. George
Colin Tuno.
There you go. So, anyway, guys, listen, I'm going to play you this next segment. However, we're going to sign off now until part two. But, any last words? Oh, shit. One more thing.
What?
Actually, guys, listen, if there's anything you want me to talk about in the next part, just questions, stuff, listen, the Q&A segment is still open. You can email us, cjstryker@live.com, tammydugger@live.com, or go on our Facebooks, on my Facebook, Tammy Kelly, on her Facebook.
Don't ask.
Facebook group Stryker Network Live, guys, okay? So, you know, anything you want to talk about, criticisms, whatever.
If you want me to blast your girlfriends, I am more than happy to do it. Or anybody, for that matter.
Hey, listen. I'm not here to kiss ass. We're not here to kiss ass.
No.
We're here to shoot it straight down the middle, guys.
Yeah.
You know what? We're here to call it like it is. I'm not kissing anyone's ass. She's not kissing anyone's ass. We will praise what we need to praise, and we will blast who we have to blast. And guess what? Consequences? I really don't care about the consequences because my loyalties are not to venues, they're not to promoters, they're not to bar owners, they're not to anybody. You know who my loyalties are to? You, the audience, the people. Not just in Long Island, but New York City, Philadelphia, Boston, Charlotte, Washington, Richmond, Orlando, Fort Lauderdale, Tampa, Chicago, Houston, Austin, Los Angeles,
Raleigh,
San Francisco.
Durham.
Just remember, I have syndication worldwide. And know this right now, guys. This is not, I talk about more about New York City and Long Island because this is where we live, and I want the rest of the world to see the slice of that New York has to offer.
And that our accents really aren't that bad.
That's true, too. So, any last words officially now?
Well, just that consequences come in the form of us. You screw up, we are your consequences. You do great, we are your biggest cheering section. But don't mess with us, because we will call it like we see it every single time. Right?
That's right.
All right.
Guys, nothing, and this is to all my friends, nothing personal.
No.
It's just show business. So, now I'm gonna play you Alfie's. On behalf of Tami Duggar, CJ Stryker from S&M Studios, signing off. Alfie's, 125 Medford Avenue, or should we say Route 112 in Patchogue. Tonight, guys' night out. New night on Saturday nights. Guys running the night, George C. and the M. What's gonna be it? What's gonna happen when we get in there tonight? I'm not sure, but let's go in and take a look.
Stryker Network Live. I'm standing here with George Colantino, the owner and operator of Alfie's in Patchogue. Now, George, and tell me about your venue.
We're one night a week. We start right now every Saturday. It's basically just your everyday cheers bar where guys can meet guys. Everyone is welcome, but that's primarily what we're all about. Just giving the community another home to go to and having fun while doing it.
Now, what are your goals with this bar? Do you have any hopes, or do you want it to just be like your everybody knows your name kind of place, or do you hope to make it bigger? What exactly do you hope?
I hope for it literally to be everyone knows your name kind of environment, but yes, we are looking to expand through other nights, and hopefully, like I said, as August and everything comes closer, more nights will be taken over, and we'll make themes and everything where everyone will have a night or a chance to sit there and celebrate and mix it up. And
have gay fun. People love a theme.
Oh, yeah.
Now, tell me
what you can't get a drink.
Now, tell me what you think about the other gay bars on Long Island. I mean, you know, what are your takes on their venues?
I think everyone, they theme it in their own image of what they want to do with it. I decided to be different. I'm not catering to any specific age group or class or genre or anything. It's literally for everyone. No attitude, have fun, hang out.
That's great. Now, what is your take on, like, you know how the gay scene has changed in Long Island very drastically over the course of the last, say, 20 years. What do you think about the Long Island gay scene as a whole? Because back in the 90s, it was every block had a club, bar, there was no shortage of places to go, but now it seems like there is a bit of a shortage. So what do you think about that?
I think it's sad, but like I said, you can blame it on the economy, you can blame it on lack of support, or just it wasn't working in general. I hope to bring that back. I was part of that and came to the end of it, and I watched it crumble, and now I want to see it come back for more than just one night wonders. I know I'm a one night wonder at the moment, but I don't plan on staying that way.
Right.
I want it to grow. I want it to keep going. And
it's not to bash the one night wonders, but then do more for the community and grow.
If that's what you are, then do that. It's not about me. It's about just sitting there and celebrating and having a safe, fun environment to go.
100% with him. I did watch it crumble, and hopefully with bar owners like George, maybe we'll be able to build our community back up, because honestly, the gay people on Long Island are wonderful people, and we really do need outlets, and we really do need more of a sense of community. So thank you very much, George, for your time. And I really like your bar.
You're sexy, you're hot, and now I need a new business owner. Thank you, George.
Thank you.